Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Doc at Padama. This time we are going to discuss how to easily compute the sample size that you will be using for your study. So in this particular discussion, we will be starting with the differences between population sample, sample size, sampling method. So these are the terms that we need to differentiate before we go on to the actual discussion. So this is very important because you cannot just guess. Hindi nyo pwedeng hulaan at hindi rin kayo pwedeng mag-set ng sarili nyong numero kung ano yung gusto nyong numero na kunin na magiging sample ng inyong study na magmumula doon sa tinatawag nating population. In relation to this, kailangan malaman muna natin para sa kapakanan ng mga hindi pa nakapanood ng mga nakaraang video natin, yung pagkakaiba ng population ng sample, ng sample size at sampling method. So simulan po natin dito bago natin ipakita kung ano yung paraan na pwede nating gamitin para ma-compute ng madali itong tinatawag nating sample size. So simulan po natin dito sa tinatawag nating population. Pag sinabi natin population, ang keyword na pwede nating gamitin dyan will be the totality of participants. Yung kabuuan, pangkalahatan na bilang ng mga magiging kabahagi ng inyong research. So halimbawa, ang population ninyo ay pwedeng students or pwede naman siyang unang halimbawa natin students or yung susunod ay pwede naman mga teachers. Okay. Or halimbawa, kapag medyo higher level na yung tinatawag nating research na ginagawa ninyo at ito ay may kinalaman sa pagpapatakbo ng eskwelahan, administration, supervision, and operation, pwede ang participants ninyo ay tinatawag nating halimbawa principals or school heads. Okay. So halimbawa, lagyan natin ng numero yung mga estudyante. Ang total population ang pinag-uusapan natin ng mga estudyante na gagamitin ninyo ay aabot ng halimbawa 1,800 students. Okay? Yung teachers naman, kung teachers ang gagamitin ninyo, yung mga teachers sa iba't ibang eskwelahan, halimbawa limang eskwelahan, bawat eskwelahan merong 100 teacher o merong 110 teachers at lima yung eskwelahan, gawin nating 550 teachers. At kung principal naman ang magiging respondents ninyo, so yung principal natin, ilagay natin na halimbawa, syempre, ilan yung gagamitin ninyo, isang rehiyon. So halimbawa, ang principal ninyo ay 10 o 20 principals sa isang region na gagamitin ninyo, ganong kalaki. O halimbawa, 3 district, 20 principal. So itong mga numero na nakikita ninyo, ang tawag natin dyan is population. Yun yung kabuuan. Okay? Now, pag ang pinag-usapan naman natin ay yung sample, ito yung representation. Representation of the population. So, ibig sabihin, ito yung magiging representative ng population at dahil sa sobrang laki ng population ninyo, kumuha lang kayo. So, itong kukunin ninyo, ang tawag natin dito ay sample. Okay? So, that is what we mean by sample of the study. Now, yung tinatawag naman nating sample size, iusog lang natin dito. Okay? So, pag ang sample size naman ang pinag-uusapan, ito naman yung specific number of respondents. Specific number of respondents. So, dito sa sample size, dito natin gagawin yung computation. Again, napakarami pong paraan para makuha ninyo yung specific number ng respondents, kagaya dyan sa definition na binigay natin. Meron dyan yung gagamit kayo ng Slovin's formula. Maliban pa sa Slovin's formula, marami pa po kayong pwedeng gamitin. And then yung gagamitin po natin ngayon na mas madali at pinakamabilis na paraan para makuha nyo yung sample size, lalong-lalo na kung napakalaki ng number ng population ninyo. Now, yun din natawag naman nating sampling method. Okay, dito tayo. Sampling method, when we talk about sampling method, this is the process of selecting, ilagay natin yung definition natin. This is the process of selecting the respondents, the sample of the study. So, itong mga sample na ito, sila ngayon yung sasagot ng instrument natin. So, imbis na yung population ang sasagot ng instrument dahil sa napakarami nila, ito ngayong sample, which is the representation of the population, identified through computation kung gaano kalaki yung sample natin, ang tawag natin doon is sample size, ito ngayon yung i-compute natin. So, ano yung pinakamabilis na paraan para makuha natin yung tinatawag na sample size? Ulitin natin, ang sample size, hindi pwedeng hulaan, hindi pwedeng kayo yung magsiset, kasi karaniwan, madalas, lumalabas yan na tanong during the defense. So, itatanong sa inyo ng panel, how did you arrive at the sample size of your study? So, this is what you're going to do. I-compute muna natin. So, ang computation natin, gagamitan natin ng isang application na yung iba sa inyo, narinig na, pero for the sake of those who just tuned in and watch our reference video, yan, okay? So, the name of the application is Rousoft Calculator. So, all you need to do is to click Rousoft and then click nyo lang tong option na Rousoft Calculator. And then, after that, the first option, which is www.rousoft.com, click that link. After clicking the link, you will be directed to the menu of the sample size calculator. Actually, this is just a one-page menu. So, there are spaces na mayroong mga numeric values na ang tawag natin doon ay naka-default na. So, if you're going to observe other researches, makikita nyo nakaset na sa default yung mga sumusunod. Kagaya ng number 1, the margin of error is also usually set at 5%. So, naka-default yan. Confidence level, sa amin, inilalagay namin sa 95%. Naka-default din yan. And then, yung response distribution is also by default nakalagay sa 50%. So, what do you need to do? This particular part, which is what is the population size, here on this part, yung minomodify ko, you only need to enter the numeric value that you need to use, the numeric value which is a representation ng population ninyo, para makuha ninyo yung tinatawag nating sample size. So, remember, earlier, we set the population for the students at 1,800. So, to make sure here, in our sample letter A for the students, we have 1,800 students. Now, papaano nyo malalaman yung tinatawag na sample size using Rousoft Calculator? So, all you need to do is just enter the value 1,800 and immediately here, the number 317, which is defined as the recommended sample size. So, the recommended sample size for 1,800 is 317. So, if we're going to place it here, sample size for the students. So, letter A for the students, we have 317. So, is that correct? So it's 317. So that's correct. And then the next one is if we are going to use teachers and the total population of teachers is 550, ilagay na natin yung sa principals. Okay, so teachers are set at 550 for their population. So let's use that and enter the value 550, enter, and then immediately you're going to see the recommended sample size, which is 227. Okay, 227. So what do you observe? The lower the value of the population, the higher the sample that you need. Okay? And then for the principals, what if you only have 20 principals as the population? Okay? So let's enter the value 20, not that one here. So let's enter 20 and then look at the recommended sample size, which is 20. So let's enter it here. So for the principals, you will have to get all of the principals as your sample size. Okay, so again, the sample sizes for the following examples that we use are the following. So these are already the computed sample size. Sampling method, I did not emphasize it anymore because this was discussed in my previous video. There are two classifications of sampling method. This is the process of choosing, example, 317 students. How would you choose 317 students from 1,800 population of students? So this is where sampling method will come in. So in the sampling method, the two classifications that I mentioned earlier is what we call probability and non-probability. And non-probability. Again, under probability, you have specific sampling methods. Under non-probability, you have also a set of sampling methods that you can use in order to identify the computed sample size that resulted from using Rousseau calculator. So basically, this is how you compute for the sample size of the following examples that we gave. From 1,800, you have 317. From 550 teachers, you have 227. And the lowest value, if you have 20 principals, you will have to get 20, the total number of 20 principals as your sample size. So thank you very much for tuning in and watching this particular video discussion. And I hope this will be able to help you. I'm sure this will help you in coming up with number of sample size for your study or the study that you are conducting. Again, there will be recommended videos that will appear on the side of your screen. These will focus on specific parts of your research. And again, this will definitely help you in writing these parts of your research. Again, please do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that notification bell to alert you when a new video has been uploaded. Thank you very much, everyone. Stay safe and God bless. And I'll see you on our next video. Goodbye, everyone.